How's it going, my truant people? Dr. Slacking, the Slacking Doctor, back with week seven. It says it on the screen, thank goodness my face cam might be covering it. But for week seven of the UBL, I had no idea what week it was, versus Root and his New Jersey Brobats. His channel will be linked down in the description. Huge shout out to Root. I don't know if this game is going to count towards the final standings. We might be over the deadline. We were supposed to play last night, which I believe was the deadline for all of the games to be completed for this season. But I was ill. I wasn't very well at all. And a huge thank you to Root, who already has put up with me being a pain for scheduling. Agreed to then play a day later. Whether the game counted or not, to be honest, I just get on very well with Root. We always have great games. And he just said, do you want to just play anyway, like as an exhibition game, whether it counts or not? And I was like, yeah, sure. So I've checked the website. I was given a forfeit for my game against Vepsis last night, which I was also supposed to play, but I was ill. Which I had said to Vepsis, can you play today? Which was tomorrow, yesterday, and he was like, no, I'm at work. So I said, it's fine, I'll take the forfeit, it's completely my fault. But that game had been updated with a forfeit, this one hadn't been, which makes me think maybe Auto is allowing us to play this game and for it to count, otherwise he would have given me a forfeit for this one as well. Maybe. That's just me speculating based on very little information. But regardless, we have another game which will be up after this, which did count, so stay tuned for that. Which is more important. I don't know. It's very hard to explain. Because it actually counted. That's why it's more important. So, the team I've brought here. We've got a bulk up Cobra Berry. Pretty bulky Urshifu. We've got a Swords Dance. Bulky Extreme Speed in. Lucario. We've got a physically defensive Flip Turn in Primarina. We've got an Encoring Fast Whimsicott, I believe. Yeah, pretty much just fast Encore. We've got a agility safety goggles Porygon, meant to help out with the Amoongus basically. And then last up we have a stealth rocking kind of mixed defensive Piloswine. So with that in mind, I think I want to get rocks up early, because this game's supposed to be done offensively, which means I'm going to need chip on everything. So rocks seemed like a good way of achieving that as we just get in there. Looking at my opponent's team, Lucario could do really, really well here if I can chip down the Dragapult, which is always a very hard thing to chip down. So maybe if he's like a sub-Dragapult. Let me just quickly run a calc on max speed Dragapult. So we do see the Barrascuda lead. Thought we might. He can poison jab or flip turn if he wants to here pretty freely. But I'm going to go into the Primarina, as that is the physically bulkier of the two things that I've brought. As he just goes straight for the liquidation. So how much is that going to do? 181 to 124. Looks as though I need to get about 40% off on his Dragapult to clean sweep that, certainly. What did I say? He did about 60 points of damage, right? Something like that? I don't know. Just trying to see if this thing's banded. Didn't see a life orb. So he's about 33. Yeah, I think he's banded. I think he's, so I'm going to flip turn here. We have the Draining Kiss, which is pretty nice, and the Protect means that we should be able to stay pretty healthy throughout this game. Yeah, as I figured, we'd probably see the Amoongus come out here, so this is a nice flip turn for us. We can bring in one of our Wall Breakers to try and take... Oh, is he's Rocky Helmet? That's not great. But that's good information. That's really good information. Okay, so I think this is the way that we want to try and wall break here. His Dragapult is the closest thing I can see to a switch into this. So I'm just going to try attack, because going hard Dragapult is pretty risky if I'm sub or something like that. Even clicking Spore is a bit risky if I'm sub, to be fair. But I just think I want to try and break. Yeah, I think I just want to try and break here. just want to try and break early, not over predict. I'd love to Dark Pulse, trying to catch the Dragapult, but I don't really feel the need. I don't think there's a huge need to do that. Okay, so Primarina's down to about 55%. So I need to play that cautiously. I could do with getting some protects off on it, maybe making some doubles into it at some point. I would have loved to have Dark Pulsed here. I really wanted to do it. But if he's Spideff Mandibuzz, he should be Fizz Death Mandibuzz for the Urshifu. Maybe I should have Dark Pulsed here. No, he does stay in, so this is going to do a whole lot, I would imagine. He's possibly AV from that damage. This time I am going to Dark Pulse because the next Tri Attack wouldn't knock him out anyway. It covers his switch if he wants to try and go into the Dragapult to regen this thing up. I am adaptability on this, aren't I? Yeah, wow. So I think that's an AV Amoongus, even without Calcing, to be honest with you. Because yes, I'm not a boosting item, but he might think I'm Scarf from the fact that I haven't shown a boosting item there, which is another reason to cover the Dragapult play, because he might be like, ah, he's choice locked into Tri-Attack, or just expect me to go for another Tri-Attack. So we just cover that play. We now lose the bluff of Scarf, but that's fine. Don't poison me. Ugh. I want to recover. If it hadn't poisoned me there, I would have recovered. Because, again, that would cover him making the bowl play into Dragapult here. But I've just shown I'm willing to Dark Pulse, so maybe he won't do that. So I've brought safety goggles for no reason because this thing's got the assault vest, which is fine. Maybe recover would have been a good mid-ground. Did he go into Dragapult? Did he pull the trigger on that? I don't think that's... No, okay. This is going to do a lot. This is going to do an awful lot. Yeah, nice. Big damage. Let me think. Porygon can still revenge kill on the Mandibuzz, on the Stunfisk, and on the Amoongus. But he also kind of can knock me out of the Surf here. I'm still gonna do it. Like, I always want to go Whimsicott, but he could also Hyper Voice. He has a couple of options here. I wouldn't be surprised to see a Surf come out here. But I'm EV'd to take anything but Spec Surf twice. So as he actually just goes for the Volt Switch, so that's pretty nice. I'm now gonna get my Rocks up. He can Surf if he wants, and as I say, I'm EV'd to take anything but Specs twice. So we should be fine. As he goes into Fish, what's Fish? This is Fish. That makes sense. This thing can put on some pressure. I definitely do want this around still. This is still really, really useful. I am worried about the Poison Jab because I think it's a fine play, but I'm going to go Primarina. I kind of want to stay in and predict the Poison Jab. But I think Liquidation's a fine play or Flip Turn's a fine play by him because in kind of both scenarios, he gets just good chip off on my Primarina or gets momentum, so and just covers me staying in. Yeah, the Flip Turn comes out, that's fine. This thing's choice banned. I was pretty sure from the damage roll earlier, but from the way he's playing it, I'm even more sure now, so that's fine. So we should see the Amoongus again here. Probably Stomping Tantrum Amoongus. I'm going to protect, get the extra turn of leftovers, get that passive recovery. He's not Assault Vest. He's just really Spideff. Wow. Really Spideff. Well, that wasn't a good turn for me going for that there. Not a good turn at all for me. Sludge Bomb, Synthesis. Does he have the Spore? Does he have the Giga Drain? Ugh, I'm not keen on using this because this is supposed to be one of the win cons, and but I'm being greedy because I want Porygon, and I do have other ways to win this game, but I am being greedy with this. He does go for the Sludge Bomb, okay. So I think we might see a Stomping Tantrum here. Yeah, we do. Which is going to do a lot, but I'm pretty bulky, so we are going to take it. And then because he's so heavily Spideff, we should be able to knock him out here. So I didn't really want to use Lucario as the breaker. Lucario was really supposed to be the sweeper in this game. If I was feeling greedy, I'd SD again here, and then I'd probably win the match on the spot. But I don't know if I'm feeling that greedy. He could just stay in. That would put me in such a good spot, though. Best case is he goes Dragapult here, and then that would put me in another really good spot, actually. Because that might give me the chip I need on Dragapult, but that would be... I don't think he's going to do that. When he goes Dragapult to Revenge Kill me, I think I'm just going to Bullet Punch and take my chip on it. I'm going to struggle to win the game without this, though. I am going to struggle to win the game without this. It's going to be a lot on Urshifu's shoulders, which is fine. Yeah, good job I didn't Swords Dance again. Take the Rocky Helmet chip. So if he's Aqua Jet on the Barrascuda, then that will put him in a good spot. But getting rid of the Amoongus is still pretty nice for... okay, this comes out. It's still pretty nice for our Whimsicott and our Primarina. So it's no bad thing to see that Amoongus go down. Do I want to save this? The priority's so nice, but I'm never going to get to plus two again. No, I think I'm going to take my damage. I think I'm just going to take my damage. This should do quite a lot. Yeah, that does a good chunk. As he U-turns, was that going to KO me? I wonder if that's any kind of damage roll to give me an idea. Like, if he was a special Dragapult, for example, would that kill? That could give me some information. So, U-turn from, like, a choice spec set, for example, is what I'm thinking here. What health was I on? Was I on about 15 HP? Yeah, I think that means he's got to be, like, a physical Dragapult. Maybe I was on 12 HP. I still think that means he's got to be a physical Dragapult, so that's good to know. What the hell did he go into? I think he went into the, Lizard, didn't he? Yeah, I was going to say, I'm pretty sure I heard the cry of this thing. I think this thing's Scarf. So that's why I've gone into this. Yeah, he doesn't really have a good Moonblast switching anymore. If he is Scarf, then... Shit, he's Scarf, man. I should have gone into the... Into the Piloswine or the Piloswine. Ah. Wow, didn't expect that. Okay. That explains why he switched out earlier. This is super, super bad for Dragapult, really. Depending on what his Dragapult set is. If he's sub-Dragapult... This got real tough. It's got real tough. Urshifu's definitely the win con. Urshifu's 100% the win con. So if he goes Dragapult here, he's going to Steel Wing or Phantom Force, isn't he? But I do still have a full health Piloswine. Dragapult. Dragon Dance Dragapult. Steel Wing's not even a 2 KO, not even close, with Life Orb Adamant. So, he's not Life Orb, we've seen that. He could be Choice Band, but bear in mind I have Ice Shard, so just taking one is pretty sufficient. Oh, this is actually kind of okay. Okay, so... Am I going to lose to Barrascuda? Yes. Yeah. So I what I'm thinking is if I go into Primarina on this, which would be something I would consider, then I'm going to end up losing to Barrascuda, so I'd rather just... okay, so he has got some Spadef, because I EV'd this thing to basically 2-hit KO Mandibuzz with no Spadef. So, it sucks that that we don't quite pick up the 2-hit KO there. Could be a damage roll. I'm going to Moonblast again anyway, just in case. This thing's a huge roadblock to Urshifu. That sucks he got Rocks down, because obviously that's good for his Barrascuda. Okay, so if it is a damage roll, it's not one that we're winning. I can tell you that much. Obviously, we are getting leftovers back, though, which is pretty nice. Do I just want to stay in and keep spamming while I'm getting leftovers back? I think I do. I think I do. Get healthier and healthier. We know it's banded Barrascuda. The less things he can choice ban himself into, the better. These damage rolls are interesting. Okay, we can Moonblast. We can potentially PP stall him out of Roosts. I don't know if I don't know if Moonblast has more PP than Roost, though. And of course, the whole time that we're doing this, eventually we could crit. It's kind of the dangerous game we're playing here. If I'm going to U-turn into anything, what would it be? Primarina and Draining Kiss? I think that's going to be weaker than this thing's Moonblast, right? Even though Primarina is significantly stronger, the fact that Draining Kiss is just a shocking move. This is why we never run Draining Kiss. Draining Kiss 33 min, Moonblast 4, yeah, significantly weaker. So, although I would get some recovery, I would probably get knocked off or, you know, something, so it's just not worth it. As he does decide to switch out, obviously realizing that, he doesn't want to take the crit and that we're just getting tons of recovery. So, Energy Ball's going to do about twice that damage, I imagine he's going to want to get his own rocks up here. So, I could Energy Ball or I could get my own rocks up in return. I think that's better. He could have Scald on this, but I'd be able to take the Scald. I don't think he's going to Scald into Whimsicott. I'm not U-turning because I don't want to get static paralyzed. So that's why I'm not making that play, as he does go for rocks. Yeah, well, if he's getting rocks, I'm getting rocks. So that's all fine. We just need to get an opportunity with Urshifu. Once we have an opportunity with Urshifu, we can start to do something. We're going to Earthquake once here in case it goes hard Barrascuda. Yeah, good, because that might just put that in range of Sucker Punch from Urshifu. That's huge. That's huge. Okay, I thought he would make that play knowing that I'm essentially trading rocks with him. There's no way I live a banded... God, I love Barrascuda. Such a cool mon, man. There's no way I live a banded liquidation with this, is there? I might, you know. I might. I do. I do live even an adamant banded. Yeah, I'm going to take my KO. I'm going to take my KO. Oh, he flip turns. Of course he flip turns. That makes perfect sense. That makes perfect sense. That was a greedy play by me. That was a greedy, greedy play by me. So we should see the Mandibuzz now. I'm going to Stealth Rock on the Mandibuzz. Yeah. Okay. I don't know if this thing can knock me out. It will outrun me. I don't think it can knock me out, though. So I'm going to get my rocks up. Then if he wants to defog, I'm going to Toxic. Is he actually Toxics? I think this is okay, because I get my Stealth Rocks up this turn. I Toxic next turn. And then if I can spam rocks, I die because I'm poisoned. They will stay up because I will die to the poison. Or if he falls into Ice Shard range, I can Ice Shard him, but... As he goes for the Roost here, perhaps deciding that it's okay if we can both have rocks up. That sucks, because if he defogs this turn... He's not going to, because he wants the Porygon to go down. He wants the Porygon to be dead to rocks, I think. So I don't think he's going to defog here. So I'm going to Toxic. I'm not going to Stealth Rock. I think getting this thing Toxicked is more valuable. I still have Porygon saves and offensive sack later in the game. I think he values his rocks more than I value mine because of the Porygon. Take Stealth Rock's chip. We get the Toxic off. He's trying to save that Mandibuzz for Urshifu, which does mean we can potentially set the Urshifu up on the Mandibuzz. How, though? How do we force the switch there? Ugh, how do we force the switch there? I think I outrun this. He could double back to Mandibuzz. So I'm going to Toxic again in case he wants to pivot back to Heavy Duty Boots Mandibuzz, trying to make me die to poison damage while not taking any chip. Yes, we call it. We get the call. I can make plays. I can do that. We can make plays. Can we win the game? I don't know. I'm not so sure. But we do get this thing poisoned, which is amazing. It's absolutely amazing. Is now the time to go for game with Urshifu? Urshifu, Mandibuzzed, defensive, Brave Bird. Brave Bird should do 22%, and then the next turn it should do 30%. Yeah, I think this is game. If we play this right, well, he could have Toxic on this. Has he already shown Toxic on this? Yeah, he's already shown Toxic on this. So I think his play is actually Toxic here. But I still think we have to try and break through his whole team here, and then we can maybe do it. We can maybe do it in the end game. As he reveals the Air Slash. Wow, I didn't even think about special. Doesn't do too much, but it's going to do twice as much next turn. And my bulk up isn't going to affect that. Ah, that's really, really, really not ideal. I'm going to go to break him now. Because... I'm not going to have enough turns otherwise, so let's just get all of this recovery that we can get as we crit him. If he roosts here, this would be fantastic. he actually Toxics, okay. So, I don't know if this is going to be enough for game. I don't know if plus one's enough to sweep him. And it all depends, of course, if he's Colba Berry Dragapult, if he's Sub Dragapult, if he's Will-O-Wisp Dragapult. Like, I'm relying on Sucker Punching the Dragapult, so... there's a number of factors still to go into this. So I'm going to Drain Punch again here. If he goes hard Dragapult, good play. Yeah, I should have clicked Wicked Blow. Nah, that would be a crazy play, I think. I think I can afford to be greedy and get the extra little bit of HP back. Ugh. Can I? Yeah, because what's the point of saving this? Oh, I don't know, actually. I should have clicked Wicked Blow there. Yeah, I should have clicked Wicked Blow. It's just a coverall play if I click Wicked Blow. He can Will-O-Wisp, but he can't burn me. We can try and play some Sucker Punch shenanigans. So he can't switch infinitely because I have rocks up. So we can try and dance around my Sucker Punches with switching for a while, but I do have rocks up, so it is going to chip through his team. Unfortunately, I don't have any priority left. The idea was this was supposed to wall break, as it's done late in the game, and Lucario was then supposed to pick everything up with Bullet Punch and Extreme Speed. Unfortunately, because of the way the Amoongus played out, me letting him have that synthesis on it and stuff, and getting the Porygon poisoned, just put me in a position where I've had to do this instead. So, I'm just going to Wicked Blow here. I've got no idea if it knocks this thing out or not. Maybe Fizdef will take a plus one Wicked Blow. I really don't know from this range of health. But I think my best play is to click my strongest move. I don't know his EV spread. I haven't got any information on this thing. As it does live, Jesus. It's impressive. It gets off an Earth Power. I'm guessing he doesn't have anything to outplay a Sucker Punch, potentially, then. But I can still lose to Barrascuda and Dragapult in this endgame, which sucks, but that's how Mons is. I am going to Wicked Blow because I don't think I can afford to let him go Dragapult here. I want a Drain Punch, but just in case he makes that play. This is going to be real close. This is going to be real close. Do I switch... Should I have switched out to reset the Toxic Timer on this thing? And just save my Sucker Punches? I could have had two Sucker Punches in the endgame then. Maybe. Maybe. I don't know, it's all going to come down to Primarina and Whimsicott. So he does take Rocks here. I feel like he's just going to switch. I feel like he's just going to switch, but... Because he lives another rock switch in, so he can. I feel like he's just going to switch. Oh, he's Aqua Jet. Okay, so he had the Aqua Jet the whole time. Of course, that's going to fail because he moved first. Well, do you know what? I don't mind that because we lived on one. It would have been some kind of damage roll and I would have felt a little bad. So he's locked into Aqua Jet. I think I'm better off keeping my health on the... fuck, what am I better off keeping my health on? I think I'm better off keeping my health on Whimsicott. And there's a couple of things here, like one, this thing's quite low after rocks. Two, he can't switch into hard into Dragapult. Well, he could and then lock into Poison Jab to win the game. Yeah, so I have to Drain and Kiss here, because if he goes hard Dragapult to reset the choice lock on this thing, okay, he doesn't, like, so I was going to protect there into Drain and Kiss to give me the max HP possible to try and live a hit from Dragapult. But then if he had switched this out into Dragapult and then brought it back into Poison Jab, I would have just not killed the Dragapult and he would have been in a better position. Now I know 100% what my best play is on the Dragapult, because I think the way he threatens me most is to Dragon Dance or to sub disable. Right? Right. So I always just attack. I don't try and protect. If he sweeps me with like Banded Steel Wing or something, or Banded Double Edge. Then there's no point in protecting because I wasn't gonna live a, like, yeah, okay. It's just all on if Whimsicott can live this Double Edge. Is he Choice Banded? Is this gonna drop? Oh, Whimsicott, my most drafted mon ever. Can you live this? I have no idea. I really don't know. Is he choice banned? We outspeed him. He was slower than us. The one thing that I just realized as I was saying that is I think he would have killed himself to recoil and we would have won the game with Porygon that couldn't live rocks. So I think actually we would have won that even if he had outsped us. Wow, what a game. Root, man. Root, me and Root have... Go and check him out. Me and Root have the best games, I swear. Like, every time I play him, it feels like a classic to me. Like, it comes down to these, like, weird situations. Like, in this game, for example, I think me earthquaking on his Barrascuda is really what turned this game for me. Otherwise, I think I would have really, really struggled here. We just always, like, we both play aggressive, and it just makes for these great games. I love playing Reap. That's why, even if this was just an exhibition game, I wanted to do it, because the games against Reap are always fantastic. He's a very good player, and I just messaged him saying GG, another classic game. I love playing Reap. It's very fun, very fun. So, if this game counts, I believe we are now in UBL playoffs, regardless of the result of the game that you haven't seen. If this game doesn't count, I don't know if we are or not. So you'll have to watch next week to see what happened next week. But yeah, maybe we're in, maybe we're not. Watch next week anyway, because that might be the one that actually decides whether we're in or not. Because this one might not count. Oh, very confusing. Regardless, I hope you guys have enjoyed this. I know I did. Thank you so much for loafing around with me, and I'll catch you again next time.